remember when word art was a thing? I've moved on, but my love of text effects and animation hasn't. I'm still obsessed with them, making designs look way more professional and eye-catching. Stick around and I'll show you how to apply a broad range of text effects and animations that will change the way you design your next Instagram post. Hi, I'm Nano, a designer from Canva Design School. I hope you're ready to start doing things differently because what I'm about to show you, it's a game changer. In today's tutorial, you'll see how Canva text effects and animations can transform the look of a design, capture attention, and keep it. Now for a bit of inspiration. I'll show you how each one can be applied to Instagram post designs created for different purposes. Our first design is an Instagram post advertising a New Year's Eve party. Before I even apply an effect, I'm going to change the font to something more lively. There's a font I've used before called Neon, which I think will be perfect. So I'm going to tap it in here. All right, that's more like it. I'm going to add an effect. It's a no-brainer to use the neon effect here. It's like they were made for each other. Let's leave that for now and move on to our next design. Here's another Instagram post, but this time it's advertising an artisan bakery. I love this one, so I'm not gonna touch that, but let's see what happens if I place a shadow behind it. As you can see, the shadow is currently white, so I'm going to change it to match the logo. I also need to adjust the transparency to make the color more solid. Great, that's much better. The shadow creates greater definition between the letters and the background. The text is popping out and I really like how the brown helps to tie everything together. Actually, one more thing I would like to focus on is the logo. I'm going to curve the text using this tool here. It will help free up some room for the croissant to be enlarged and centered. Let's switch things up and look at a post for a sports brand. I'm happy with the font, but I think there's too much solid black. I'm going to apply a hollow effect on this line and maybe this line as well. I want to create some movement, so let's see what happens when I change the transparency. This fadeaway effect makes me think of a fast-moving object, which works well with the theme of the post. Here's another post that is product-based. First of all, I think the design could do with a little bit more color to break up the white. Instead of changing the color of the text, I'll try the background effect instead. I like it, but I think I'll remove the rounded edges to match the angular logo and font. That's better. Now, all I have to do is switch the colors. Now, I want to focus on the main heading. The letters overlapping the image are becoming lost, even though the tones are slightly different. This can be avoided by using the lift effect. It's subtle, but it makes a great difference. For this design, it just doesn't feel like it's hustling enough. I'm going to go with the echo effect because it ties in with the repetitive lettering. Super quick, but look at the difference it's made. Just be careful with the offset on this one. Too much and it will start to make it hard to read. Here's another design featuring repetition. Maybe this time I'll try the glitch effect to give the text more color. The elements across the photo already have a tech feel, so I think it will work well. Yes, I love it. Except I don't want to introduce a new color, so I'm going to select the blue and red combo instead. Here you could add a little bit more offset, so it's more noticeable. Next up, we have this colorful design made for Instagram. At the moment, it's looking a little bit flat, so I'm going to use the splice effect. This helps create depth and makes the overall design look more interesting. Now that we've covered all those text effects, let's look at how animations can be added to attract and keep a viewer's attention. I'll go through the same designs for you to see how they can be brought to life. Remember how I used the neon effect for this design? Turns out there's also a neon animation that gives the illusion of flickering light. I love how professional this looks. Now I'm going to add a wipe animation to the info at the bottom. This will help the viewer take everything in, not just the heading. For the bakery design, I want to apply a subtle animation. This one called Breathe should do the trick. It creates just enough movement to catch your eye without being too loud. Activewear needs something that will increase the sense of movement, so I think shift is gonna work really well here. Since the heading has two lines, I'll try the merge animation. Then for the smaller text, I'm going to use the block because it's simple but effective. In this design, I would like to see the words drop or move in sequence. Sometimes it's just a matter of testing out which animation creates the desired effect. I like the shift animation, so I'll play around with the direction I want my text to enter from. On this one, I'm going to put a patch animation of neon. And then on the text, I want something that really jumps out. Maybe stomp? For this post, I really want to keep it cheerful. I think we can do that with the scrapbook animation. Once again, I'm going to apply it to each individual text box as well as the graphic behind. That way, they will animate at slightly different times. Now that you know how to apply text effects and animations, I think you're ready to see what's possible when you combine animated graphics as well. Check this out. See how the text changes from white to black as the worm moves through? We've done this using the hollow effect with a solid layer behind it. Not sure what I mean? Let me explain it. First, I'm going to write "Be Active" using a thick font and capital letters. Next, I'm going to duplicate it using the hollow effect for the top layer. Now, I'm going to get the worm graphic and insert it between the two layers of text. As the worm moves, it gives the impression that the text is responding to its movement. It's really good, isn't it? And one last thing you should know. Everything I've shown you today can be used to make animated videos like this one. All the principles are the same, except you will need to use the Canva video editor to put it all together. That way, you can add your own footage and transitions like this. It's cool, isn't it? Really makes a difference. Wanna see another? Isn't it awesome? Thanks for sticking with me throughout this tutorial. I hope you gain all the confidence and inspiration you need to start using text effects and animations to bring your designs to life. Let me know in the comments which text effect or animation is your favorite. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel to be notified each time a new video like this drops.